My name is Kevin Kelty. I'm a senior and I go to Lance Coos North. And this was for the criminal justice class for Mr. Grinham. I won the third place medal at the statewide competition for Skills USA in the criminal justice category. To win this medal, I had to do a number of events. We first started off taking a written test out of 50 questions just on basic criminal knowledge, criminal justice knowledge. And after we did a series of events, starting with like a home invasion, and what we had to do was respond to it in a way where it would be, we'd be responding to it in real life. It was all run by the state troopers and state police, so they were running the whole competition for the criminal justice portion. And we had to do scenarios like home invasion and assault and battery was one. And we did a traffic stop and arrest, and we did a real job interview with the state police, which was a lot of fun. That was my personal favorite. And the last one was responding to a neighborhood dispute. Well, it first starts out at the regional level, which is here done at Penco, and it's about, depending on how many schools show up, it can be anywhere between 5 and 8 people. But they take the three best scores from each school, and then the fourth best from the second best from the overall school. And they take the best out of the regionals, and then they move on to the state level. And when you're at the states, you're competing. When I competed, there was 20 people there, but I'm sure that the number probably changes depending on how many schools show up. And overall, once you, there only one moves on to Kansas City to compete in the national, and the person who moves on was the gold medalist, which unfortunately I didn't get, but I'm still pretty happy with the bronze, so. It was a good experience overall. For the future, after high school, I'm going to go and attend Macomb Community College for a year and get all my prerequisites done, just the general admission things, and hopefully I plan on transferring to Ferris, majoring in criminal justice, and I haven't decided any other minors yet. I want to visit the campus before I make a decision first and get a feel for it. But right now, that's what I plan to do. This is just another nice thing to add to the resume, and overall, I hope it looks well. I just like being able to go there and learn about the laws and rights, and just learn the definitions of the law and things, because it's something that it's there, but you don't really know the actual definition of it. And when you get into know it a little more in depth, it becomes very interesting and. It's always involved in your life, so it's just a very interesting topic for me to learn about and to talk about.
Okay, I'm Hannah Rogowski. I'm in the 12th grade, and we're in culinary arts. I got second at regionals, which allowed me to go to states, but unfortunately I didn't place at states.
But you got an honorable mention, didn't you?
Correct. Well, there was 9 competitors at the regional competition, and we had to make a salad and an entree and dessert. And we had 3 hours to do all of that. And we had certain things that we had to do, but there were certain ways we could be creative about it. So we just, at the end, we just had to present it all, and then we had 2 plates, 1 for judging, 1 for tasting, so they tasted it. Most of it was based on the presentation, but some of it was based on taste as well. I just like how creative you can be and how people, when you put it in front of them, they're like, wow, this is amazing. I like the presenting part, but I also like people being happy about it. I'll be attending Baker College in Port Huron. They just opened their culinary campus there, so.
I'm Adam Angelucci, and I'm a senior over at Lance Coos Central, and I took bronze medal at the state competition for culinary arts through Skills USA. For the competition, what Skills does is that they'll give you a course, menu course, whether it's 5-course or 3-course, and it's pretty much everybody receives the same recipe, and you have to replicate it to the best of your abilities. So what we had to do at the state level was chicken vegetable soup, and then a composed salad with an emulsified dressing, and then an airline sautéed chicken breast with a tomato mushroom ragu, julienne vegetables, and then a rice pilaf. And you have 3 hours to do that, along with chicken fabrication, knife cuts, just setting up mise en place. Well, we bring our equipment to there, so all my knives, all of you know, just my utensils and equipment that I need, I'll bring to the kitchen, and they supply obviously your burners, your ovens that you're able to use. And you use the college's facility where we were at.
Okay, and they supply you with all the vegetables and...
Yeah, they supply you with all the food as well.
Okay.
Actually, all 16 of us, actually, in the competition, we were all in one of the college's kitchens, and we had two burners and then an oven below us, and we pretty much just all work side by side. And I went last year, and so I was kind of used to it. I was kind of used to the whole scene, and I took 10th last year as top 10 in the state, and was one of three juniors there, so I was able to return this year as one of the tougher competitors, and you know, I was really able to just focus in on you know, my time management with everything. I was, you know, it was all just clicking with where I needed to be with everything throughout the 3 hours that I needed. I mean, this is what I'm gonna be doing for the rest of my life, and you know, a lot of people, you know, ask, you know, tell me, oh, well, it's gotta be nerve-wracking, you know, going through that, and you know, 3 hours to do all this, and you know, you better hope that it's right and everything. And it's just like, you know, a lot of things, you know, make you nervous in life, and you know, different things, you know, put people on edge and suspense situations and that. But in the kitchen, you know, I'm at ease. You know, I can take one thing at a time and get through whatever, you know, throws at me. My skills build up year after year, so I mean, from where I'm at right now to where I was at last year is just really, really a tremendous improvement, I think, and I can't wait to see where I'm at, you know, 5 years from now or 10 years from now. So I'll be attending the Culinary Institute of America in the fall in Hyde Park, New York, where I'll go and receive a bachelor's in culinary arts and management. And they do a 1 year externship or a 6 month externship after your first year there. And I want to do that through Mark Vetri in Philadelphia because he's an Italian chef there, and hopefully go and work there after school or gain an Italy contact through there so I can go overseas back over to the motherlands of Italy and train there because that's my passion is Italian cuisine.
Hi, my name's Kelly Harp.
I'm Brittany Shepherd.
I'm Chris Nowak.
We're in the CSI competition for Skills USA, which is crime scene investigation, and we went to regionals and we took second, so we moved on to states, and then we won gold at states. We have to walk into a crime scene without knowing what's happening, and we have to locate the evidence, take pictures of everything, and sketch the evidence.
And since we took first at states, we're now going to nationals. An organization to where they have a lot of different competitions to help you prepare for future careers. So like they have CSI, they have criminal justice, they have first aid, construction. There's over 100 different things that they have.
I personally was pretty shocked. I didn't expect to win gold. I think we can all say that actually Brittany was pretty shocked too.
Yeah.
But we're really excited to go to nationals.
I think the most difficult part sometimes is finding some of the evidence, but also it can be sketching as well, depending on how the evidence is positioned.
Well, we use a strip search pan. We have to use a certain search pan to locate the evidence, and you go up and down each row in the room, and you have to just find the evidence yourself. So you have to spot it. You have to search under tables, in between things, in the clothing. And you locate it all yourself, and then you mark the evidence.
But depending on what type of crime scene and where it's at, depends on what strip or search pattern you use. At states, they had bullets, there was a body, there was a hoodie with paper in the hoodie, there were hairs on the table.
There was blood on the body, and yep. Then there was also a chair with blood on it. Or some type of substance. I'm not really positive if it was blood.
And then the chairs that aren't positioned normally and if they're flipped over would also be part of the evidence.
Brittany was on the team last year, so she had a better idea of what was going on. So when we came out in the hall every day, she was the one who would tell us what to do. And so, because she was in it last year, so she knew all of our parts and we had to just learn them and memorize them. And then it was just repetition after that. You got to just get used to it, because once you're in the competition, it's very nerve-wracking. So if you're unprepared, it's going to go noticed.
Hi, I'm Alexis Allen.
I competed in the first responder and CPR competition. This is my second year doing it, and I got second. It was kind of scary, and I was kind of upset because I lost about 0.2 of a point. First responder, you basically take care of three categories of things. CPR being the first one on infant and adult. A child, it depends on who's running it. A medical part, which you do like full body assessments, take blood pressure, check lungs, heart rate, all of that. And there's a trauma part where you cover bleeding, broken bones, sprains, neck injuries, spine injuries, stuff like that. My favorite part is probably trauma, because you never know, you know, what you're gonna get when you go in. I mean, it could be some crazy thing, like someone's eye is all messed up, or their arm is like falling off or whatever. You never know what you're gonna get, so it's kind of surprising. I know I wanna help people. I'm not sure if I wanna go into the medical field or do it in the human services field, like social work.
Okay, just give me a second.
So this competition was a good, you know, start to see if I like it or not. This is my second year, so I didn't do as much preparing this year. So it took about a month, I would say, of practice. But my first year, way longer.
Hi, I'm Shelby. I was in the advertising design.
What did the competition entail? Like, what did you do?
We had to design a logo for a company and make an ad design in like a magazine, and then rebuild something out of directions they gave. I like the logo designs because I always have fun with those. I met a lot of cool people during the whole thing, and it was a pretty good experience.